Welcome to the new Casio fx-9750G3 graphing calculator. This is our newest edition, and I wanted to walk through some of the newer features and functionality very quickly just to give you an idea of what's added and what's different. So first thing is, this is a menu-driven graphing calculator, as all Casio graphing calculators are, and some of the new menu icons are the e-activity. So I'm going to just scroll over here. E-activity is new to the 9750G3, and also spreadsheets. And then if you scroll further down, there are some add-in apps that I have on my emulator software. I'm using the emulator software here, but you can also add in the Python menu icon, the geometry, the physium, and the probability. So these are some new menu icons that are now available, making this a much more powerful graphing calculator, non-color graphing calculator. It also has increased memory. It has the same memory storage as the CG50 color graphing calculator, so that gives it a lot more power and ability to hold things. Another thing that's new, and I'm going to go into the run matrix menu, which is where you would do your calculations and things like that. And when we click either execute, or I can hit this number one that's under the icon to get in. So I'm going to hit execute. So I'm in this menu, and anytime you're in a menu icon, you can go to the setup for that menu. So I'm going to go to the setup and show you some of the modes that are now available here. So if I hit shift setup, you'll see my input output. I have three options for this calculator: math, linear, and mixed math. So the default is always math, but you can change it by clicking these functions here to linear or math mixed. And if you're wondering what is the difference between these modes, it mainly has to do with how solutions appear, particularly with radical numbers. So I'm going to leave it in math, the default mode, first, and I'm going to show you a calculation. So I'm going to say, okay, I'm excited about that. It works. I'm going to hit execute. So now I'm going to find the square root of 18. So if you notice, the square root symbol is above the x squared. So I'm going to use the shift x squared, and I'm going to type in my 18. When I hit execute, I get the standard version, the simplified version, 3√2. If you don't want that, then you can hit this button right here. This is a new template, this standard to decimal, and see this decimal version. But this gives you the simplified version in radical form. Some teachers don't want that, and so if you don't want students doing this, if you want them doing this by hand, you don't want the calculator doing that, then you would want to switch the mode. So let's go back and show you the difference. So if I do shift setup, this time let's go to linear and hit execute. We're ready to go. Notice what I did before is gone, and so now we're going to do the same thing: shift square root button, and then we want the square root of 18. So notice this is in now linear mode, how it would look on a calculator that doesn't have the ability to do standard notation. And so it looks a little different. You don't see the square root symbol, the radical sign, all the way over the 18. When I hit execute, I only get the decimal version. And because I'm in linear mode, I can't convert it to its standard form or its radical form. So that's, if that's what you want, if you only want students seeing the decimal version of the answer, they can't toggle back and forth between the standard and the decimal version, then that's what you would want. And also the square root symbol looks a little different here. So now let's see what the mixed mode looks like. So we're going to go back to setup, and this time we're going to do F3 with his math mixed mode, and we're going to hit execute. And notice the minute I did that, I got my square root symbol again that went over my numbers because I'm not in linear entry. So now let's do square root of 18. So this version right here was when we were in math mode, and remember, we could toggle back and forth between the decimal and the standard notation in radical form, simplified, and the radical symbol goes all the way over. So now I'm in math mixed. So let's do square root of 18 again. So it looks very similar to start with. When I hit execute, I get the decimal version, but again, because I'm in math mixed, I can't change it to the simplified standard form. But the difference between this and linear is that square root symbol is all the way over my number that is under the radical. So just different versions of things that you can do. So I'm going to go back and switch it to its default, which is math. And I wanted to talk about some other functionality here. So let's just delete what we have here and start with a clean screen. So I wanted to show you another new feature, and that's order of operations, implied versus implicit. So let's just do a typical order of operation problem. 6 divided by 2 times 1 plus 2. Now, this could be interpreted, because it's linearly written, this could be interpreted a couple different ways. Parentheses, we would add 1 plus 2 first, and then if you're really following true order of operations, you would do division and multiplication in order. So you would do 6 divided by 2, which is 3, and then 3 times whatever this solution is, which happens to be 3, so 3 times 3 is 9. So the answer should be 9 if we're doing true order of operations. But sometimes maybe you really meant 6 divided by 2, where you would write it as a fraction form, but let's say you didn't write it, you didn't use the fraction template. So the calculator now will basically interpret for you, and then you can go and change it. If you don't put parentheses, so if you really wanted 6 divided by 2 to be grouped together, when I hit execute, the calculator now will show you what it did. It actually grouped it for you, and it got the solution of 1. So it has, because it assumed that you, because you did not put the parentheses around the 6 divided by 2, or you did not use the template, then you must have meant first add, then multiply by 2, and then divide 6 by that entire quantity. If that's not what you wanted, then you should have done the following. 6 template divided by 2 quantity 1 plus 2. And now you get 9. So what happens is, if you're doing something, it will automatically show you how it had interpreted it, put parentheses to let you know how it grouped it. And if you realize, oh, that's not what I wanted, you can go back up and change it, right? So I could go in here and say, well, no, what I really meant for you to do was this. And let's delete that. This is what I really meant for you to do. Oops, I did something. I forgot to get rid of that parentheses there. And now the answer is 9. So it's sort of forcing, and I love it, because it's telling you, here's how we interpreted it, and if this was not the interpretation, then you should have used the template or used parentheses to really clarify what order of operations you want. So it's a great tool for students. So that's another addition in there, that it really kind of shows you how it did the order of operations. There's also, let's go back to our menu, and I'm going to go into stats, where you would enter data and all this stuff. But I wanted to show you the different, there's some regressions that have been added here. So if you're familiar with the Casio 9750G2 and the 9860G2, we've added a lot more regressions to this G3, 9750G3. So you'll see that down here we have our regressions, we've got exponential, power, sine, log, all those right here. So there's just more regression options for you in the statistical window. And then if we hit exit, again. So I can also go in and show you that there's, if I'm in my standard things and I go into options, you'll see I have probability. So we've added some probability features. So if I hit F5, you'll see that we have lots more probability functionality. So that you can do as well. So we've increased that. Another thing that we can do, if we hit exit, let's get back to our menu. Let's scroll down to link, and I'm going to hit link, and there's going to be another video on this, but you'll notice that we can actually do exam mode on this calculator now. So there's going to be a video on how to put the 9750G3 into exam mode, but that is now an option that is available. The buttons here have changed. We've got our fraction template, our standard decimal template, and down here for exponential, our scientific notation, you'll see that that button's also changed. So it makes it just easier for students to recognize that this is where they would enter, you know, your scientific notation. And if we actually went into, let's go into number 1, run icon, and I wanted to enter a number into scientific notation. Notice when I hit the button, it puts that there, but that is now interpreted as 1 times 10 to the third. And so that's what that's doing. So this button looks a little different for them. So those are just some of the options and changes, and we're going to be exploring more of this specific menu options as we go along.